Hey guys, thank you so much for stopping by the garden today. I just wanted to pop on and do a little video on my succulents because we're getting into the hotter weather here and my succulents are sucking up a lot more water, except for these little guys. You know, these are a lot different than my other succulents. So when I'm talking about succulents in general, these are totally excluded from that care because these are split rocks and lithops, and these things, I mean, they get rotted if you look at them the wrong way. There is a lot of humidity in the air. They tend to suck that up. So they're kind of hard to grow here in Central Florida, Zone 9B. And I just wanted to pop on and do another little video for you. I did one for you guys a couple of months ago on these when they just started to grow that middle growth. So you can see that middle growth is just starting to take over. This one totally popped out, you can see, and it's starting to take over. Those two bottom leaves, one of them already deflated on this one and the other one's starting. These are nice and plump and really, really firm. These are little lithops, which they flowered for me. This one flowered, as you can see, that little flower chamber is kind of still hanging on there. And then these are the little lithop leaves starting to pop in. So these little bottom leaves are going to start deflating and becoming really wrinkly. You can see how wrinkly they start getting. And that is totally normal for them to do that. If you're seeing that happen, you guys, that is totally normal. These are going to start wrinkling up and they don't need any water at this point. And that's why I wanted to pop on and do this little video for you. So I don't give any water for a while. I've only watered these once since I got them, and that was a year. I've had them a year and they've only been watered once, a little bit in their soil. You can see this is kind of rubbery feeling a little bit. That's the only way I know how to explain it. And these leaves are really deflating and these are really plump in the center. So you can see that center growth really starting to take over, and it becomes wrinkly a little bit, those leaves, but you can see it doesn't wrinkle as much as the lithop does. So they do become really deflated, and you don't want to give water at this point. You want to let that top growth suck up all that water from the bottom, and then what's going to happen is it'll take over, and then we'll think about giving some water once this takes over. This middle growth takes over. It needs to deflate a little bit or become wrinkly like this, and then we go ahead and water. So we don't give any water during this process because they tend to become overwatered. And if these split rocks right here have any more than two nodes on them, so they should only have like two nodes on them. If they have three, that bottom set should be on its way out the door, because if these have any more than three sets, that means you've kind of overwatered too much and they will end up rotting out in the long run. I've done that, and I got one of these split rocks with that Phalaenopsis, I think it's called, Phalaenopsis Nelly. I got one with three stacks on it a couple years ago when I first started growing these, and I didn't know about them, and it rotted out on me because it had the three stacks. Somebody had overwatered it just a little too much. So we're going to let these go ahead, keep wrinkling out. As you can see, they're really, really wrinkly on their foliage. We're going to let them grow nice and beautifully in this 6 to 8 hours of direct sun. So they do stay in 6 to 8 hours of direct sun with the rest of my succulents. And we'll be back with another video once we're ready to water those and the process that they go through once they start deteriorating those bottom leaves. Thank you so much for stopping by, you guys. I hope you really enjoy this video. And if you need any help at all on growing any succulents, just let me know. I'm always here for you, and I'd love to help you in any way I can. Thank you so much for coming by, you guys. I hope this really helps you to keep your split rocks and lithops happy. Mimicry plants, they're called too. You'll hear them called mimicry plants, stone crop plants, or lithop split rocks, Phalaenopsis Nellies. There's a bunch of names for these. If you guys need any help, just let me know. Thank you so much for coming by. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.